Hi there, and thank you for tuning in. I'm sitting here with my beloved Nikon D700, and I got a question from Dragan. I hope I'm saying or pronouncing your name right. I will put the message here on the screen. But the question was basically, when you're shooting in continuous mode, that works fine on the Nikon D700, and what then happens when you add flash? And I assume here that Dragan is talking about the built-in flash, and let's give that a try. That's not exactly continuous, is it? I've studied the manual, and normally I praise Nikon's manuals, but in this case I will say I was not able to find an answer to this. My guess is that this has to do with the battery power and its ability to recycle the flash. So what I typically do is that I add an external flash like this one. This is an Godox V860 Mark II. Let me do like this so you can see it. Looks like this. I'm not pushing this product especially. I just really like it for several reasons. And one of them is that apparently Godox is of the opinion that a battery stays in the compartment until Godox tells it to come out. So I managed to get the battery out of the compartment, and you can see here it's a lithium battery. And that is pretty powerful. And if I add that to the flash, then I have a pretty good combination here, because it's a powerful battery. And that means that the recycle time is strongly reduced relative to, for instance, the batteries that there are in the camera itself. So if I put this on top here of the Nikon, and then, you can hear I'm still in continuous mode. Can you see this? Maybe better if you do like this. That works a lot better, right? So that solves the problem. But I will say though that I am only in continuous low, and also that I have adjusted the flash, the strength of the flash here. You do that by pushing the little button here on the side of the camera. It sits right there. If you push that one, you can on the top LCD see, you can see here if I turn the front command dial and hold that button in at the same time, then I'm changing the exposure compensation. Your flash obviously doesn't fire at full power every time. It depends on many factors, such as your camera settings, whether you're shooting TTL or not, on manual mode, and all of these things. But be aware that the more power your flash has to give for every shot it gives, the more taxing it is, and the more demanding it is to recycle and come back and be ready for the next shot, right? So some of the issues you may experience if you can't get it to move fast enough, so to speak, to keep up with a continuous shooting rate, could be because your camera settings and what you're trying to do demands that it fires at full power every time. So try to use the flash compensation just to see if it makes it work a little bit better. So what to do if you have a flash with more traditional batteries? These are, I believe, AA batteries, and these are not rechargeable. Of course you can get them rechargeable, but I can assure you if you use something like this, it will be very difficult to keep up with continuous shooting. So if you use batteries like these, even though you use them as rechargeables, you will become very good at switching batteries because they will run flat in no time. And I also think that recharging or recycling times will not be very impressive. So what you can do is, if you have, you need to check your own flash, but if you have one of these little plugs on the side here where you can have external power. So here's the connector you need to have on the side of your camera. And I'm holding here the cable that fits into it, next to it, but you need to check with your specific flash that this is possible. But what this does is that if you have an external power source option here, what you can do is you can buy, and I'm not pushing this product especially, I must say, but you can buy one like this. This is a ProPack PP960 from Godox, and this is an external power supply or power bank, I think you would call it. And it fits into the side of the flash like this. And now the flash has extra power. It is so that the flash for running the internal you know, the rear LCD and all of that. It needs some power, and that it gets, still gets from the batteries. But the power required for firing the flash, that is now from the external source. And I assure you, this can make a huge difference in terms of the how quickly it recharges. So now you can see I have the external power source plugged into the flash. And then when I shoot in continuous mode, you can see it can't exactly keep up, but it's not bad at all. And again, as I said, it depends on the actual settings on your camera, whether your flash fires at full throttle every time or not. So I hope the point with this video comes across, that it is to illustrate that you can solve the issue that you can't shoot with continuous mode with the built-in flash. You can do that with an external flash under certain conditions. But I'm no expert on flashes at all, so please don't ask me too many questions here. I just wanted to show you that this is the direction you could take in order to solve the issue that if you try to shoot with the internal flash in continuous mode, then it can't keep up at all. Yep, as always, thank you for watching. Take care. Bye-bye.